What's up, y'all? What's up? What's up? What's up, y'all? We would like to welcome you all to week 11, Truth Be Told, Meaning Behind the Music. This is the series of the questions and the answers, and along with me is the lovely last lady, Angie Calhoun. Like we said in the video earlier, we want everybody who has a question for either one of us to address the person that they have the question for. So if you just put a question out there and don't nobody, we neither one of us know who it applies to, let us know. So be like, this is for Cut. And let us know where you're from. Let us know where you're from and then who the question is for. Like, I'm so-and-so Joe Blow from blah, blah, blah. And this question is for the last lady, you know, and vice versa. But this question is for Cut, and then have your question. We're going to, oh, okay. You let them know how to go. No. Oh, go ahead. I'm not even in it. They're right there. Go ahead and talk.
Come on. Everybody, we're tuned in. Is it not in? I don't know. Let's
see. It says 7%, so it's like it's still charging. All right. Sir Garcia. Hello. Once again, to everybody who's just logging on, welcome to week 11, Truth Be Told, Meaning Behind the Music. This is the question and answer series. And you can direct your questions either towards me or towards the lovely last lady, Angie Calhoun. Thanks for logging on. Cut, when can you make a song with Big Crit or J. Cole? When can I? I don't think it's up to me. That's up to the Lord. I don't know when I can. I already did a song with Big Crit featuring Tech N9ne, That's My Kid. As far as J. Cole, I like his music. I actually like his music. So shout out to J. Cole. He does his thing. You know, I wouldn't reject doing a song with J. Cole at all. So yeah, I don't know when that will be, but I definitely will. Do we have any more questions pertaining to the 10 videos that we did on the Truth Be Told, Meaning Behind the Music series? And once again, you can direct the questions towards myself or the lovely last lady, Angie Calhoun.
What's wrong with that?
And just be focusing when we're getting close and be back. All right. What up? Hey, Cut from Baltimore. What's going on? What's up to all of y'all that's logging on here? When is your next show in Dallas, Texas? My next show in Dallas, Texas, I don't know. I don't have it planned out when my next show in Dallas, Texas is. The way it happens is that the promoters that's in Dallas, Texas, if they want to bring me, the promoters will reach out to Black Gold Entertainment, and then they will set forth a contract and an offer, and then that's how everything gets taken care of, and then the show will start getting promoted and so on and so forth. Does this mean we can make them pop up? King Cut, what's good? Much love from New Mexico. What's up, King Savage? Are you coming to Australia anytime soon by any chance? I will be coming to Australia. I want to speak that into existence. A lot of y'all may not know. The reason I wasn't able to come to Australia is because I've had child support arrears. They've been in the arrears to where when it's over a certain amount that you owe in back support, then you're not allowed to travel or get a passport to go out of the country. But all of that is going to change, is about to change. And so I will be to Australia, definitely. To say particularly when, I can't say, but I would definitely be going to Australia. Much love from Alabama. Solid. God bless. God bless you too. So y'all know that we're supposed to be on here for an hour. We're here for an hour, just taking an hour out of this time to be available to answer questions, preferably about any of the videos that you guys have watched on the Truth Be Told, Meaning Behind the Music series. What's up, bro? Long time no hear from. I remember when we was at, I remember when we was at what?
A pageant in St. Louis in a freestyle. You did a freestyle.
We was at a pageant in St. Louis and you put my name in it. You put my name in it. That was a while back with Big Bro. I'm so proud of you. Much love, Jason. Much love. Is there anything you'd rather say?
Oh, now I can talk.
I told you to talk. Got out of the camera.
So for those that are just tuning in, like he said, we are here to answer any questions you guys may have about any of the videos that was done for the Truth Be Told 1 through 10 series. Let us know what you got. No holds bar. Any questions you may have.
Yeah, so anything from where I've been, where I'm going, all the way down to A Time to Kill. My brother Demolish did a beat on your what? On your Cut Loose album. Oh, that's what's up. Shout out to you, Jason. Jason Mass, the booth. You ain't liking how that set up. Mm-mm. There you go.
I don't know.
What's the, with the
because quarter. It was like it was sliding that way. Can you do that again? Mm-hmm. Tuned in, just waiting for you guys' questions.
Hey, Cub, been a fan for a long time. Heard you're on a song with an artist from my home by the name of Tiny Toon. But wanted to ask about your inspiration for the song Truth. Thank you so much, S2GS. S2S. Simeon.
Second seed.
My inspiration for the song Truth was exactly what the song is titled, Truth. And it was time for me to unleash the truth. I've always been very personable with what I put in my songs throughout the years of all the albums and EPs and mixtapes that I recorded. But this particular album was the most truthful, the most vulnerable, the most personable album that I've ever done. And what this album consisted of was not just your average tracks out there talking about partying and kicking it and this and that. This actually was just like a honest, personal, vulnerable, all about my life, you know, whether it's been good or bad. And I had to just put everything out there. And Truth was actually one of them songs to where I had to, I had to vent and get that out of my system. I write about it. Music is very therapeutic, but I also just had to tell my truth to you guys with this walk that I'm on and this spiritual journey that I'm on. It was my duty as a follower of Christ and the servant of the Lord to put out there everything that I've done, you know, in hopes that it can be a blessing to somebody else to where it can either be preventative or it can just let you know that, you know, that your favorite rappers or your people that just you may have an image of thinking that everything's all good and they're living so well and they're living so happy, you know, couldn't nothing be going wrong in their lives. It's just to let you know it's the total opposite, man. I'm human. I wake up every day just like you guys do, man. And, you know, I've had faults as well. So what inspired it was nothing but what it's titled was the truth. And I was ready to let the truth be known to everybody because I have nothing to hide. You know what I'm saying? Is there anything you want to piggyback on? Mm-hmm,
that was for you. Okay. What made you put Joker on Alive?
Joker. Well, actually, I was sending... Shout out to Joker. I was actually sending Joker Alive... Because the beat that I had was from someone else, and I was sending it to Joker to see if he could remake the beat, and he remade the beat, and it already had a hook on it too, and he was like, "Yo, Cub, you gotta let me redo this hook, man." You know what I'm saying? He was like, "The song's cool, but it can be more powerful." So Joker actually redid the beat. He put some extra stuff in the beat, and he killed it with that hook, man. You know what I'm saying? Yes, I did. I knew he can sing. I knew he can sing all the way from the maestro. But yeah, the Joker decided to send that back to me, and he gave me more than what I was asking for. So it ain't like I decided to put him on it. Joker kind of took control and was like, "Here, let me do this for you." And boom, and laced me with it. And I didn't disagree with it at all, man. I had no complaints about what the Joker did. Shout out to Joker, that's my dude. He's he actually mixed the whole album too. He mixed the whole, truth be told. He didn't mix it. Rob Rebeck mixed it. Sorry, Rob. Rob Rebeck mixed it. Joker mastered it or whatever. So shout out to Rob Rebeck and Joker. These are two of the best engineers that I know of. So much love, y'all. When you coming back to Ohio? You know, any places that I'll be going that I may be touring or be coming to do some shows at, I would definitely post it. So it's kind of hard to just say, hey, I'll be in Ohio February 2nd. You know, shows have to get booked, tours have to get booked or whatever. And that's how it all starts to form and comes into play or whatever. So if and when and once I have tours and shows set in place, then I will be posting them. And anybody in any particular state or city, you guys will know when I'm coming there, because of course I will post it. I won't leave you guys in the dark. Hopefully that answers the question. Your words have helped me get through some stuff. Great feeling. Thank you so much, Gianna Romero. Thank you so much. That's Johanna. Part of Johanna Romero. That's a part of this ministry that the last lady and I are doing, Angie and I. A part of the ministry, part of our ministry is to put our truths out there, to put not only the wrongs that I've done, is to put out, you know, how it's affecting my wife and how she's dealt with it and what she's done to overcome. She's been getting asked questions like, girl, how do you do it? You so strong, oh, you so courageous, and how do you do it? You know what I'm saying? So that's a part of our ministry right now. That's what the Lord has us doing, is putting our truths out there, our lives out there, just transparently out there in the open in front of everybody to see. We're not trying to hide anything, and it's to help,
you know? Absolutely. And you know, I said in one of the videos, a lot of people want to keep things like this secretive and don't want to tell, or they're embarrassed or they're ashamed, you know, that their boyfriend or their wife or whatever, their husband cheated on them or whatever they're going through, or that they've been molested or whatever the situation is. A lot of people are afraid to talk about these things or to share it with someone, whether they're embarrassed or feel bad or heartbroken, whatever that may be. But again, we go through things so that we can help other people. Life is difficult, and we do not go through all of these things and all of the hardships of life to just keep them in and hold them all in and keep them to ourselves. When we go through it and we get over that hump, we are supposed to then help others that are going through the same thing. So that's what it's about. So great, great news.
Well spoken. Thank you. I have an issue I'm going through. I have a friend, and we were a couple, but we broke up. But we still are in each other's life, and we be around each other a lot and do things together as if we were still a couple. But she is dating someone else, so I'm asking, should I let her go or stay in her life?
That's difficult. Jason Mask, what you have to think about here is being around her. Is that making your feelings grow? Because time, absence can make the heart grow fonder, but also spending time with someone can make you grow feelings for them. So the fact that you all were a couple and now you're not anymore, if you're still spending time with this person, it's only going to make your feelings grow more and more. And if she is seeing someone else, you have to wonder, am I just setting myself up for failure? So you need to kind of find out where this is going. If you guys are just going to be friends, if she's telling you, no, we're going to be friends and that's it. Yeah, we can hang out, but we're going to just stay friends. Then you have to decide, do you want to continue on with this kind of behavior? Because in the end, it may leave you being the one that's hurt because you're steady building relationship feelings, but she's into someone else. So that is something you're going to have to determine for yourself if you're willing to go through the hurt, if this friendship and this hanging out doesn't turn into more than what you expect.
Yeah. God bless you on that.
Great question.
Yeah. What up, Eric Gonzalez? All right.
You got my lady making me bump on the way every time I'm home. Thank you.
Oh, much love. Much love. Definitely. I had to give praise. I had to give praise to the queen right here. I had to. You know what I'm saying? A majority of that album, not only was it just truthful, but it was kind of, I don't want to say dark, but the subject matter was kind of dark, because it was a lot of stuff that I'm admitting that either when I was in the streets, you know what I'm saying, doing wrong and how I grew up, or the stuff that that I've done wrong. And so, you know, on the way was definitely a tribute to my lovely wife, and I had to, you know, I had to shout her out. You guys are hearing what I did wrong to her, but and you know, thinking about, oh my God, how she could be feeling and this and that. But you guys also don't know that, you know, our whole relationship, our whole marriage wasn't just all dark and bad and gloomy and cloudy. We've had wonderful times, but just knowing who she is and learning more and more about her throughout all these years or whatever, along with the past that we have of all the good times, man, it's a lot of things that I needed you guys to know. I ain't gonna say I needed you guys to know, but if I'm putting out the truth, then the truth in on the way, you know, was something definitely that need to be shared as well. You know what I'm saying? So we appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? I had to let you guys know how I really feel about her, her character, her personality. She's been there since day one, the type of woman that she is. You know, I can sit here and talk about what I did to her and the things that I did wrong, but that's not letting you know who she is. So I wanted to further let you know, not only did I do all these bad things and stuff that I regret and whatnot, but let me let you know, you know, the type of woman that I had, that I was so stupid and did all this dumb stuff on. Let me let you know the type of woman I had, and just to let you know how good God is. That's another reason that we're doing these videos and stuff, because it's nothing but the grace of God that got me with this woman who is so angelic. She is, man, you know what I'm saying? I don't know another woman like her. You know what I'm saying? And so that's letting you know that if a man can do all the stuff that he did to a woman such as her, and she can endure it and go through the fire with you, and we still be together, that's nothing but the grace of God. And that can give some people hope. That can give some people faith. That can give some people a gleam of light at the end of the tunnel to let you know, just because things went wrong in your marriage or relationship doesn't mean that it's the end. You just never know what God can do in your life. So I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Let me see.
I want to thank you. Me and my wife watch you and your wife open up about divorce and giving each other another chance. It helped us grow stronger and rebuild our marriage. Wow. I don't know if we should say their name. Maybe they don't want it. I don't know.
Right. Much love to you.
Yes. And that's wonderful. And that's what it's about. You know, if we can help one couple, we have done something that we were called to do, because that's what it's about. So many marriages, the divorce rate is tremendously out of control right now. And so hearing that is awesome. Thank you so much. Glory be to God for that.
Yeah. And you're welcome, Jason. I see you said thank you. And I'm thinking about it too. Do you guys mind if we say your names? Because I think about it, like, when this is over, people can see each other's comments anyway that was on the chat and read the questions. So it's all the same. You guys ain't got nothing to hide, right? You shouldn't, you know? Are you doing features? Dylan Foote, yes, yes. I didn't talk to you a couple of times. Yes, yes. But hold up. Taylan Clay Combe, would you ever consider, if Tech offered, doing an 816 Boys album? I tell you this, you know, we haven't talked much these days. You know, he's a busy guy. He got a lot going on and whatnot. But if Tech called me, I would first say, let me get the call first before I can even answer that question. Let me get that call first. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not opposed to anything. If you know, where I stand at, man, with in my journey, my spiritual journey now, I'm definitely all for doing something positive and making good music. You know, so an 816 Boys album, I don't know, you know, because you know what the 816 Boys is about. You know what I'm saying? Talking about a lot of girls and a lot of sex and a lot of oochie coochie and poo wah wah and all that stuff. So I may not be doing. Flip the camera?
No. Yes. Did I?
Yeah.
Oh. No, you flipped it now. I didn't flip the camera.
Okay. I may not be doing an 816 Boys album because that's not the life I'm living now. So I wouldn't want to be fake. I would want everything to be genuine. So I don't know if I could do an album that calls for me to be talking about some having some sex and some chicks and some bunk rocking and all that stuff. That ain't where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? That part of me is dead. But good music, doing music, I'm all for that. So I hope I answered your question, Dylan.
Are you doing features?
Am I doing features? Yeah.
Are you scrolling up?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm doing features. And if you want to feature Dylan, you can hit up my email at cuttycal@gmail.com. cuttycal@gmail.com. And that's only if you're serious. So anybody else that's listening, you know, don't just start hitting up my email to say, hey, cut, what's up? What you doing? Don't do that, man. Let's just try to keep it professional. So for serious inquiries only, for people who want features, I am doing features. And so if you want to know what the pricing is, and if you want a feature for real, Dylan, hit up my email, cuttycal@gmail.com.
A Time to Kill made me cry when I first heard it. Thank you.
That was from Dylan as well.
Mm-hmm.
No problem, Dylan. You know, and if it made you cry, man, I can understand, because the type of song that it was, I don't know if you can relate or if you just, you know, felt the, had sentiment for, you know, the subject matter, but either or, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, in week 10, you need somebody to talk to. You can always talk to folks like us, you know what I'm saying? And, try to talk and get things out if that's the case. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to leave here without suggesting that and feeling like I left a void there to where I'm just letting you know that if you need to talk to somebody, brother, that's what the last lady, Angie Calhoun, and myself are here for.
Absolutely.
Definitely. What's up, Bloody Cuddy Cal? A tour in the near future. Definitely so. Definitely so. I just want to tell everybody that 2020 is going to be a big touring year. With the grace of God. With the grace of God. Let me see. S2S, second seed. Hope I'm not only limited to one question. Of course not. But I wanted to also ask about your label and what's going on with that. Will you have any artists coming out, or are you looking for artists and producers? I tell you what, Black Gold Entertainment still stands, and right now I am the only artist on it. Do I have prospects for artists that I would like to sign and actually be on the label? Yes, I do. And so, am I looking for them at the time? I'm not looking for them. And there's a couple of reasons why. You know, with this whole Truth Be Told, Meaning Behind the Music, these series and stuff, that has should have let you know the things that myself and my family have been going through. So I know that you possibly can imagine that while all that was going on, I'm not sitting out here trying to sign, scout, and look for people to sign. You know what I'm saying? But you know, we've been we've made a breakthrough, and God has blessed us to be free from everything that we was going through. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so I want to sit here and just say that all of that stuff is in the future, and all of that stuff is possible, but I can't give you a direct answer on who, what, when, where, and why. You know what I'm saying? All I can say is that, you know, whatever the good Lord, you know what I'm saying, allows to happen, it will happen. And if it's meant to happen, it's going to happen regardless. But the reason, you know, to answer your question, you know, since before all this stuff started happening, before this year, you know what I'm saying, before last year, I've always been having my eyes on certain people. You know, Daniel Automatic from the 206, he was one of them that I did the video Never Know With. You killed that, boy. I don't care what nobody say, you killed that. Shout out to Daniel. You know, he's a prospect because he's dope. He's talented. You know what I'm saying? My son, King, you know what I'm saying? You guys may have heard the song that him and I did called Rude Awakening. You know what I'm saying? Of course, my son. And there's another guy out there, you know what I'm saying, named Marco. You know what I'm saying? He's in a situation right now, but I got my eye on him too. So it's definitely people that I've been planning to get with, that I want to work with, that I want to possibly sign. And far as producers go, you know, I got a I can't necessarily call him my producer, but I'm gonna call him my producer, Tali Blanco. His name is 11 right now, but he produced every track except one. He produced 9 tracks out of 10 on Truth Be Told. He also did Shooting Gallery on the whole Cutting Loose or whatever. So I'll say I have one producer right now, but am I looking for producers? It's not that I'm looking, but if somebody sends me some material, whether it be music, lyrics, or beats, then that's how all of that stuff evolves. So to say if I'm looking for it or not, most people don't care if you're looking for it or not. It's like if you're hungry, you send stuff anyway, and whether you get contacted back or not, that's a chance you gotta take. Closed mouth don't get fed, but you know, I'll leave it at that. Why you skip my message? Tammy Dunfrey. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. What message did I skip? Mm-hmm. Let me know what you said. I didn't see it. It must have been at the very beginning.
No, we didn't get no message.
We don't have it. We don't have it, Tammy. We don't have it.
Send it again, Tammy.
Send it again. Hey, this is Kehana's brother, Ronan. What's up with you? You're a good rapper. Thank you. Thank you. I'm everything that God put in me, that's all. Nothing more, nothing less. No, we have nothing to hide. My name's Josh, and my wife's name is Sarah. Thank you both.
Hi, Josh and Sarah.
Josh and Sarah, much love to you. God bless you.
Keep going strong.
Keep going strong. Sierra B., proud of you for the change you've made. You can tell your music. I relate 100%. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Jason, what you talking about? I for surely need you on my new album, JM11. It's about what's going on in the world and black on black crime and how our women are disrespecting themselves and how social media lies are the new truth and give the truth on it all. I love that. That's right up my alley. You might need some spoken word from Miss Calhoun too. That's dope. I like stuff like that, man, because a lot of people, you know, people say they love the truth, they want the truth, but then when the truth gets told, they don't want to hear because the truth isn't what? The truth isn't entertaining. And I only say that meaning like the truth being spoken just in a general conversation isn't what the world wants to hear. But when people see the truth of the matter is that there's killers in the world and serial killers and psychopaths and this and that, or people that do psychopathic stuff. When it makes the news, everybody wants to watch. When somebody's about to jump off a bridge or a building, everybody wants to watch. People love that type of stuff, and that's the truth. But if you got on TV and social media and you just start telling the truth about things, people don't want to hear that. So I like the truth because the truth will set you free, and more people should start telling the truth. You know, it's our duty as artists or as entertainers or anybody that has an influence or has an audience that listens to you and goes off of what you say and you got people's ears. The truth needs to be put out there, you know? Is it true? Got a song coming out with NF. Who's NF? I don't know who NF is. Is it true? You got a song coming out with NF. I don't know who that is. Gotta let me know who that is. Kehana Romero, nothing. What about
that
you?
That was Ronan. That's her brother.
Ronan, nothing about you when we said, what's up? Well, you see what we doing, man. We sitting here working. We sitting here working. Your cut, your wife, and you are true blessings. I thank you. I am a lyrical alchemist myself, but obstacles are stacking. It will not stop me because music is my passion and the music is my power. Thank you, Black Gold. I know to keep pushing. Exactly right. Exactly right, man. You got to keep pushing because nothing's easy in this world, whether it comes rapping or basketball, sports, or whatever you're doing, a job, a position that you want. Nothing is easy, you know, and I had to learn that the hard way as well. I always wanted to skip past the lessons of life and just make it straight to smooth sailing, and that's not how it works, man. Nothing is easy, and if you want it hard enough and dedicated enough, then you know what I'm saying, that you'll stick in there and you'll be the last one standing. And so definitely know that if it's in your heart and it's something that you want to do, it's worth putting in the work to do it and the work to get there if this is what you want. So don't ever give up.
Nofi, you said the magic words. You said you got to keep it pushing, and I can't say it better than T.D. Jakes. You got to keep it moving.
You got to keep it moving.
Keep it moving. If you don't keep it moving, you might miss your blessing. So keep it moving. You got to get to the other side to see what's on the other side for you.
Yeah.
So amazing.
The blessing is in the struggle.
That's right.
If you're not struggling, you won't be blessed. If you're looking for easy street, you know what I'm saying? People want the promise, but they don't want the process. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you have to go through a process in anything that you're trying to be or want to be or looking forward to be successful in. There's a process, there's steps to go through. And if you skip certain steps thinking that you can get down to the end of the line, you're going to get moved back and you're going to have to repeat those steps. Mm-hmm. So make sure that you're willing to go through the process. And if you're not willing, don't even attempt it. R. Lopez, Sr. That's what's up. Hope you hit Tucson, Arizona again, Lil B. Again, I'll be there like I always am when you hit my town. Yo, Angie, keep cutting check. Ha ha, you're doing a good job. Isn't she? Hit me over the head, baby. Boom.
It's a tough job, but somebody got to do it.
She's keeping me in check. Her and the Lord, they on my back heavy. And I'm telling you, I'm so thankful, man. I'm so thankful. People get an outcome like I got. And so that's even more of a reason to continue praising the Lord, seeking his face, and letting him guide me as a man, as a husband, and as a father, man. I'm telling you, it's such a blessing. It's such a blessing. I'm so blessed and lucky to have her, for real. I don't deserve her. I don't. So, yeah. Come to Spokane, Washington. As I said before, if we got when shows come about or whatever, they will be posted. All right, Jason, you said I got 14 songs done so far, so please, I need your blessings on it, bro. I'm putting like 22 or 30 songs on the album, so please, bro, I need you on the album. All right, hey, hit up cuddycal@gmail.com if you're serious about it, Jason. CuddyCal@gmail.com. Check it out when you're done, sir. I'll shoot you a link somewhere. Okay, shoot it to CuddyCal@gmail.com. I got a producer from Kansas that gives good production on it, and Demolish is producing on the album as well. Okay, cool. So Dylan, do you have a hard time listening to your old music? Or any music that promotes sin? Do I have a hard time? No, man. So let me clear the air right now. No, I don't have a hard time listening to it. You know what I won't listen to, though? I'm not going to listen to bunk rock. Because bunk rocking is what got me in this shit that I'm in, right? And the shit that I went through, bunk rocking, for real. When I did that, I wasn't married. I didn't have ties to nobody. So bunk rock is the song that I probably won't sit and listen to. You know, that's a song that my wife likes. That's I said there's a song that my wife likes. You see how she look? Yeah. There's a song and it's SOS. She likes Sex Out South. You know what I'm saying? But that bunk rock song, she cannot stand it. And everything that I've been through then came behind some bunk rocking. You know what I'm saying? And that bunk rocking stemmed from a lot of stuff. And that's the reason. So, yeah, I don't trip on listening to my songs about songs I may mention and about some sex and this and that or whatever. But bunk rock, I don't listen to
it. He didn't say sex. He said promote sin.
Promote sin. Okay. I'll listen to Dark Nights. I'll listen to Shottas. I'll listen to, Killer City. I'll listen to, whatever. So, no.
Hi, cousin LaJoyce.
LaJoyce, good evening. Hey, cousin. Missed you over at Stacy's house, so I heard y'all had a nice time.
But she didn't go. And Brenda was there.
And Brenda? Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, we had a good time.
Hey, cousin, thanks for turning her on to the last video, the Time to Kill.
Yes.
She told Angie that you turned her on to it, so thank you. Tell her I love her, too.
Yes, we love her.
We love her. Man, I feel you both. My wife and I, and this is Calvin Walker. Man, I feel you both. My wife and I have done the same struggles, but roles reversed, and I am helping her raise a daughter that came from the mistake. I saw your video and cried. Wow. Thanks for these videos. Oh, man.
Wow. That is, Calvin, that is, it takes a big person to do that with a big heart, because most men, are not able to deal with that. So the fact that you stuck in there you are going to be a father that that daughter will never forget. You know, I don't know if her real dad is around or not around, but the fact that you stuck around and you are helping take care of her is definitely a blessing in that. So shout out to you for that.
Shout out to you, Calvin. God bless you, brother.
Yes.
And your situation.
Yeah.
You may be a good rapper to some, but you're a lyrical prophet to me. Hopefully I'll hear you playing one of my songs. Thank you so much. I am humbled. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, like I said, all that I have, all that I got, and anything that I have that I possess that you guys like, man, it all came from above. It all came from the Lord. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, thank the Lord. But I appreciate it. I'm not too prideful to accept the compliment. Thank you guys. I just, I do the best that I can do. And with the Lord's help, I will continue to do so. So thank you. So much love to you guys from Reno and what? Jerome? Mm-hmm. From Reno and Jerome. Okay. This is for the lady. What gave you the strength to get in the booth with the boys and not get intimidated? Raw and uncut, still a fade. What gave you the booth to, well, I mean, what gave you the strength to get into the booth with the boys and not be intimidated?
What song? What
they said, this is for the lady. What gave you the strength to get in the booth with the boys and not get intimidated? Raw and uncut, still fade. Well, the wife didn't get in the booth until, truth be told.
I've been on several songs just saying, like I was on Dark Nights, mm-hmm. saying that skit, mm-hmm. The one you did with you in Paris, and she,
yeah.
you know.
Yeah.
But the first one, I would say, Ease My Mind, right?
Yeah.
That I'm actually singing. Others mm-hmm. just doing skits or speaking. So,
right.
Sabrina Stranger.
Yeah, Brina Stranger.
Brina, if you could be a little more specific on that, that way we make sure we answer your question. I'm not sure we get what you're asking or what song you're speaking of.
Craig Easy, yo, cut. Love from Canada. Keep doing you. Much love, Craig. Thank you so much. I appreciate the support that everybody, all my Canadian fans, man, I thank you so much. I mean, from Canada to Australia to Finland to Switzerland to Germany to Russia to South America. You know, I fill out, Black Gold fills out sends these packages off. People that's ordering the album that want the hard copy autographed from all over the world. You know what I'm saying? So thank you so much. And everybody from Canada too. Thank you. I appreciate you. God bless y'all. No, her dad is not around. Thank you guys again. Look forward to you coming to dinner.
For sure.
Angela Triple, I love you guys. Such an inspiration.
Thank you, Angela.
We hope that everything that we talk about, something that's been helpful and beneficial to you, mm-hmm. or something that you may be able to share with somebody that you notice in need of help, you know?
Yeah.
We want to thank you for the time to hear us, and thanks for your blessings. You guys inspired us, and we are grateful. God bless, and have a good evening.
You too, you both.
Same to you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thanks, Calvin. The last album.
Yeah.
That's Cutting Loose.
Yeah, Ease My Mind. Okay. Now, the question. I don't think I really had a choice, Brina Stranger, about getting in the booth. I was terrified. I was nervous because I don't sing. So shout out to Rod Rebeck, said he didn't have to do much. But anyway, I think I set myself up for that one, because if you listen to week 3, where we talk about Ease My Mind, you will hear that I actually wrote the hook for the song. So what better person to make it in the booth than the person that would not let another title come down from that song? So,
right.
I think that's why I didn't have a choice. But
she got in the booth and killed it. Talking about how nervous she was. She got in there. She was in there by about 5 minutes. Nailed it. Layered a couple of vocals or whatever and was in and out. I'm like, you did this before.
Whatever. It was really fun though. But yep, Ease My Mind was one. We talked about it actually today when we were at the gym, that It was the first beat that I ever heard that I actually got words to in my mind. So that was a big deal for me, a first time experience to see what the artist actually feels when they hear a beat. So thank you for the opportunity. Hey, honey, just salute, just salute.
All right. Cheers from Egypt. Hey.
Wow.
Much love. Much love. Now, that's a first for me.
Wow.
That is a first. Thank you so much, man. Said I've been a longtime supporter. Wow. That's deep. That's deep.
Something's gone to Egypt before.
Really?
I think at least one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, much love. Thank
that
you.
That is amazing.
There's a Veronica Lammer. I just want to say, I have never been one of them broads, but been a fan since 2005. I am not just a Cut fan, but I am a Miss Angie's number one fan. I have said since day one, she is strong. She is strong to deal with a lot of mess. At shows, I think I get happier to see her, to be honest. You are so strong and beautiful. I look up to you and always will.
Oh, Veronica. That's so sweet.
That's nice.
I appreciate that. You know, I hear that I'm strong. I get calls, I get messages, and people, oh, you're so strong, you're so strong. And I'll tell you, just like I tell everybody else, I'm not strong. It is God that is keeping me, because with the things that I've had to endure, a person would probably be insane by now. But I know God's grace has kept me from losing my mind, to be honest with you. So I'm not strong. I know who is keeping me, makes me appear strong, but I'm nothing without God. So thank you for the kind words. I appreciate that.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We got about 20 minutes, 20 more minutes of questions, you guys.
All right. Much love. Much love, CA Maggie. It's been a strange job. I'm so glad you picked it. And thanks for those words. Love y'all and happy. Love y'all and happy, Cudi. You found your queen.
Oh,
I'm so happy too. I found her and didn't know. I had her and didn't know. So that's thank so you funny. So much. Thank you so much, man. You're an inspiration to the rap game. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Shalom.
Madaza Beats. Shalom. Shalom. How you doing? Was it a hard decision to leave Strange Music? Hard? No. Was it risky? Yeah, you know, but was it hard? No, it wasn't hard. Ease it on off too. No, it wasn't a hard decision to leave Strange. I came to the conclusion of, the best thing that would be in the best interest for myself and for the situation I'm in and for my family was to going to be able to, to remove myself from the family over there at Strange or whatever. But like I said, it wasn't nothing personal. If you listen to the song On My Own, you know, it wasn't personal. I just had to do it because had I stayed there, my personal individual situation, my life and everything that was involved in my personal life would not be what it is today. So it was in my best interest to remove myself from there because I know with me being there, you know, I would have continued down a path that wasn't in my best interest. I would have continued down a path that that wasn't the best path for me to be on. And so when we're in situations and the situation you feel like maybe is not getting better, you want better, but the longer you stay in a situation, the worse things get, you know what I'm saying? Your mind is not matching up with reality, you know what I'm saying? Your thoughts is not matching up with reality, you know? You gotta come to a conclusion of what you wanna do, you know what I'm saying? You come to a fork in the road, which way are you gonna go? Me, I chose to go straight, you know what I'm saying? I've already been down this road and I was down this road for so long, I chose to go straight, man. And like I said before, and I say it again, that was the best thing that I could have done. Much love to everybody over there. You know what I'm saying? That was a family of mine. You know what I'm saying? I've been knowing them bros for since 98. You know what I'm saying? And so it was the best thing that I could have done personally for me. You know, if that, hopefully that answers your question. You too, brother. Is that Sabusa? Sakusa?
Zalsa,
I'm sorry.
I don't know. I'm
my wife says I need glasses. Much love. Stay blessed and strong. Same to you. Bro, whether you left or not, your rap game is the same. The shit. Much love, bro. Thank you so much, Maggie. Jeff Garcia, this album is a testament to what you've become. I love it. I remember about 7 years ago meeting you at a meet and greet, and you didn't seem happy. I can tell you found true happiness. I definitely have found true happiness. I don't know if I didn't seem happy then. 7 years ago, let's see, 7 years ago, it was 2012. Man, I don't know, you know? I couldn't sit here and tell you what I may have been going through at that particular time and day and minute and moment that you saw me in or whatever, man. But, you know, I don't know. But I definitely have found happiness and glory, man. I found where I'm supposed to be. Yes, you know, in the Lord and with my family, woman of my dreams. I'll never find another. So I'm definitely happy now. I wouldn't trade where I'm at right now for all the money in the world, for all the fame in the world. Nothing. Ain't nothing more important than what I got going on right now. You know what I'm saying? But God is my witness. For real. For real. Hey, Cub, what do you do with the stuff your fans give you? I gave you a red bandana towel on my own tour. My wife can attest to that. I got stuff in the closet and stuff down in the basement that we're trying to get finished up for certain rooms down there. I keep stuff.
He keeps everything. This is to R. Lopezar, mm-hmm. I believe. He keeps everything that the fans give him. And I've seen the red bandana. It is upstairs. We have a shelved cabinet in our closet. Our working closet has a shelf with about five or so shelves on it, and he keeps everything. And my plan for him, a gift to him, we are in the process of getting some work done, and I plan to have a cabinet built specifically for all of his fan items. I mean, he has shoes, he has bandanas, dream catchers, pictures, people that have
portraits,
artwork, all kinds of things. He brings it all home and we try and preserve it and keep it clean and keep the dust off of it until we can get it in this glass cabinet. And we will post it when that's all ready. And I don't know when, because it's going to take time. He has lots of stuff, but we do keep that. And I have seen the red bandana.
Yep. So that, hopefully that answered your question. You know what I'm saying? I don't throw stuff away that the fans give me. You know what I'm saying? Especially when they didn't work so hard on it. And whether it's from a portrait to a shoe, to a sock, to a wristband, I keep that stuff. You know what I'm saying? Maggie, what is your go-to food you eat before a show? Man. I don't think there's a go-to food. Is
there? I can answer that for you. Okay. It just depends. C.A. Maggie, how long? Magpie. I'm sorry. We're saying Maggie. C.A. Magpie. Sorry. Okay. Please forgive us. It just depends. I'll answer this because I'm out on the road with him quite a bit. If he is going on really soon in the next hour or so, he will not eat heavy. If we have about 3 or 4 hours, he may have a steak dinner, something really nice. 8 ounce, 9 ounce steak, baked potato, all that, salad, wine. But if he is going on the next, 45 minutes to an hour, it's something really light because he doesn't want to be on stage and wore down.
And so, choked up all in my throat, food feeling like it's right here.
Right. So I know one of the last shows we had Chinese food, which is really light. And he was feeling good after that. So it just depends how long it is before he goes on, what his go-to food is before he goes on.
Hey, see what I'm saying? If your woman is not paying attention to you like that and can't say anything, you might want to just think about that. She's such a good person. You know what I'm saying? She's such a good human being.
You
know what I'm saying?
I love you.
Yeah, she knows me. She knows me. Okay, Big Daddy, Wildcat, what's up, Cut? Love your music and enjoy Behind the Music series. Thank you so much. I'm glad and hope that it's been helpful and beneficial to you. You know what I'm saying? Not only just entertaining, but and not only just letting you in on, you know, my life and my wife's lives and our house. You know, we've letting you into our home and into our lives. And so hopefully it's been more than just entertaining. It's been beneficial and it's been educating. And hopefully to those that's listening out there, you know, it has brought you to the Lord. It's made you want to seek the Lord. It's made you want to repent of your sins, turn away from your sins and confess them and ask the Lord to be, you know, to come into your heart and that you believe that he died on the cross for you and God brought him back to life again. And your life is about to make a big change. You know what I'm saying? So not only entertainment, but
the ultimate goal
is to let God have your soul. You know what I'm saying? And to turn away from those past evil sins and those natural evil desires. Much love, Big Daddy, Wildcat. All right, Jeff Garcia. Why does that name sound familiar? Thank you, Cut. Can't wait to see you back in Colorado. I'll be looking for your shows. Much love, brother. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'll be posting it too. What did they say? Taylen Claycomb. These words is little. It ain't that I need glasses. They're
what is your go-to song to help get you out of a dark state of mind? That's a great question.
Wow. Go-to song to help me get myself out of a dark state of mind. I would like to say I don't have a dark state of mind, but you know, everybody has the moments on them days where they're feeling down. Let's say before I even did Truth Be Told, because I'll tell you now, like I'll listen to Ease My Mind, you know what I'm saying, on Truth Be Told, something inspiring. But, you know, a dark state of mind, I listen to some John Legend. I listen to John Legend. And I'll just turn on music that has an up-tempo beat because, like we all know, music is very powerful. And it doesn't have to be a particular song. It just has to be the very opposite of how you're feeling. A lot of people... look for music or television shows. And if we're talking about music, a lot of people listen to music to accommodate the mood that they're in at that time. If you've ever pissed a woman off or you and your woman ever got into it and maybe she's mad at you, depending on what y'all argued about is the type of song that she's listening to. You know what I'm saying? And the same for guys too, you know what I'm saying? The same for anything, whatever mood you in, best believe that the music accommodates that. So I would say what I do is I go out there and get music that's the total opposite of how I may be feeling. So if I'm feeling down and out, if it's a sluggish kind of day, or I'm just feeling like, man, today's just one of them days to where, you know, I feel like my spirits is low, I listen to something that's the total opposite. But before I listen to some music, I turn on some word anyway. You know what I'm saying? I turn on a sermon from T.D. Jakes or Miles Monroe or Jamal Bryant or Charles S. Stanley.
A go-to song, a good go-to song, depending on what you're dealing with. I know for me, I have two that really get me out of places when I'm going through. And that is a song by Fred Hammond. It's a Christian song, a gospel song, and it's called No Weapon. And then I have another one by Vicky Yohe, and Vicky Yohe has lots of them. But those are two gospel artists that have inspirational music that just, you know, can bring you up out of a slump. So I hope that helps.
No weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Sing, baby.
Okay, here's Sabrina Stranger again. That's amazing to know you keep our rags. Yeah, Jerome isn't here anymore, and what I would do to get one, here's again, but glad to know you have it, for sure.
Yep.
Dylan, which copy of the Bible do you guys recommend for a newcomer? Go ahead, baby.
The Living Bible. The Living Bible is a very, very good Bible, Dylan. And the reason being, a lot of people are intimidated by the Bible or feel like they can't understand the Bible because it's a lot of thou shalt not, all of that. And we don't talk like that anymore. And so a lot of people want to read the Bible, but they're turned off by it because it's speaking in a language or it's worded in a language that's hard to understand. And you feel like you don't get anything up from it. You can sit there and read it and look at it, but it doesn't make much sense because it doesn't correlate with the English language. So the Living Bible, you can find it on Amazon. You can find it in a thrift store near your home. The Living Bible makes the word of God plain, and that's what it's supposed to be. How can you understand something that's not plain to you? And so that is a very, very good Bible, the Living Bible. And if you don't have one, you can't find one. Like I said, they're on Amazon and so and eBay. But in the meantime, if you Google something on your phone or you go to your, if you have an Apple phone, whatever you have, you can look up the Living Bible version of different scriptures. And it will read very clear and very plain, Dylan. So great, great question. For anybody listening, if you are, you want to read your Bible, but you just can't get anything from it because it's so hard to understand, get you a Living Bible. You won't regret it. Okay.
Definitely. Good. She's all around, man. She's all around. I'm telling you, man, ain't nothing better than a woman who has your back. And that's just a womanly woman, a woman's woman that got her head on right. And she's in the presence of the Lord. And she's just, she's grown me a lot. And if that makes sense to you, even if it don't, she's grown me. You know what I'm saying? She's grown me a lot, man. And so, yeah, Dylan, please take that advice, brother. Lopez Sr. I'll be waiting to see that once it gets done. I was hoping you did the B-walk with it on stage that night. Ha, that's cool. Mm-hmm. Can't wait to see it. For sure, brother. Romero.
This is Ronan.
This is Ronan. Okay.
The mother.
Oh, Yana's mother. Jeffy. I hope I said that right.
Oh, both of them. Yeah. Ronan and the mother.
Oh, y'all are truly an inspiration to our family.
Oh. Which,
thank you so much. Thank you for tuning in and listening.
Yes,
you know, you got a lot of people that what we've been talking about, you know, especially when the way we mentioned the Lord so much and trying to urge people to, you know, to give their lives to Christ, a lot of people that turns them off. But you know what? The Lord said that, you know what I'm saying, he will cover the eyes of those and the ears of those that, you know, that he don't want to get that type of message. And so for those that stick around and listen and watch this, you get a lot of people saying, oh, an hour long, I'm not finna sit and watch all of that stuff. That's just too long. It's not meant for them. But the ones that actually tune in and just and stay the whole time and listen, man, that's a blessing. It's meant for you to hear it. So we thank you so much to the whole family. Thank you so much, Ronan and Miss Jeffy. Thank you. Thank you.
Jehenna, thanks for letting them all tune in under your YouTube. Yeah. We get to say hi to everybody under one channel. That's awesome.
Much love. Much love. On my own cut, bang. Me some light in New
Bring
Zealand.
Me some light.
Bring me some light in New Zealand. Thank you so much. That's what it was meant for. All of this stuff that we talk about is bigger than us. That song is bigger than me. Yes, I was telling some truths and my feelings and how I felt or whatever, but the song was bigger than that. The song has inspired people to get up and do, you know what I'm saying, what they thought that they couldn't do, to not have to stay in a situation that they feel like they don't need to be in, that there's something better that they can do for themselves. It just was to give motivation and inspiration. And so I'm just glappy. I'm just glad and happy.
I'm glappy.
Right.
I'm just happy and glad that song has been an inspiration to you because it wasn't about me. You know, you heard me speaking or whatever, but it's past that. You know what I'm saying? So thank you so much, my brother. Thank you. Nash Carter. Would there be a gospel-inspired album? And if so, how would you structure it? I don't know. I don't know if there would be a gospel-inspired album. Gospel-inspired, I wouldn't want to put myself in a closed-off box and categorize something that said gospel, because you know what? That's going to shut everybody out that possibly needs to hear it. That's why I'm mentioning the Lord all through Truth Be Told. But you hear cuss words, you hear some street-related type of music, you know what I'm saying? You hear all that stuff that you hear me talking about before, but just probably on a more serious level. I wouldn't categorize my music and put it into just the gospel box, because if it's in the gospel box, then we would like to assume that those are the people that don't need to be reached. Amen. You know what I'm saying? And so I wouldn't say that I would do a gospel album. You know what I'm saying? I will continue to do music and mention the Lord and speak to the people the way that I've been speaking to them. That's now good. Because those are the ones that needs to be saved and possibly change their lives, or it can help change their lives or prevent them from going down a certain path.
Amen. That's a great answer, babe.
Thank you, honey. You're giving me good love. Individuality. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right. What you say is called Madaza Beats? Madaza? Madaza?
I would say Madaza.
Madaza. What does the letters of your album Blevy stand for? Boiling Liquid Expanding Vicious Explosion. It's a firefighter term that I found out about in 2000 or 2001. I was watching TV and they was talking about fires, and they said the hottest that a fire can get, the hottest intensity that a fire gets is Blevy. And the acronym was Boiling Liquid Expanded Vicious Explosion. That's like the hottest. And I always wanted to have the hottest music. I always had the mindset of when I do an album, it's like me recording my first album, no matter how many albums or EPs or mixtapes I recorded. So I've always wanted to have the top of the top stuff. I always wanted to have the hottest stuff. And that's my mentality. That's how I think. And yeah, so that's where that came from, my brother. Thanks for that question. That was good. Mm-hmm. What new artists do you listen to in hip hop, or what do you recommend? What new artists do I listen to? You know what? I like Yella Beezy. I like Yella Beezy. That boy is cold. That boy is cold. I would love to work with him and kind of guide his mind into some different things, because I noticed that he got the Lord in him. He mm-hmm. speaks about the Lord, but I would just like to guide him into just some different topics to talk about and not just hang up on all that he talks about or whatever. But Yella Beezy cold to me. I know he's young. I'm like 15 years older than that dude, but probably more than that. I'm probably about 20 years older than him. I don't know, but Yella Beezy's cold. And I get hip to some of these people, man, through my children. My daughter, she hit me to DaBaby. Pack of the mail is gone. Like I smell cologne. I like that. Suge, I like that, man. I haven't bought any of this stuff, but this is stuff that I've heard that I like. I like Yella Beezy a whole lot. I like DaBaby. You know what I'm saying? I like that a lot. And I am a J. Cole guy. I like a lot of J. Cole. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit here and say I'm an avid listener to all the new music that's out there, because some of it make me cross-eyed. But there is songs out there by certain artists that I'm like, yeah, that's dope. And I can't do nothing but give it up. You know what I'm saying? Much love. Much love to all them artists out there. But on a personal level, I can't sit here and say I'm up on all of them, because I'm not. But the ones that I have heard, you know, I'll give everybody a fair listen. If I don't like it, I don't. I mean, that's like people with my music. You know what I'm saying? They hear my stuff, they either like it or they don't like it. And that's just how it is with me too. You know what I'm saying? Do I recommend anybody? Anybody I recommend? Yeah, Yella Beezy. If you ain't heard him, I recommend him. Cut on some Yella Beezy, his first album. He only had two albums out. So go to Yella Beezy's first album. It was out like last year. You can start with the song, That's On Me, Baby. That's On Me, Baby. That whole mixtape, it was a mixtape. It ain't even an album. Dope. I liked it. I have a song that I sent to your email called Fear the Gifted. I just want your honest opinion and constructive criticism about it. It may definitely help me move forward more. Okay. No doubt. I would definitely listen to it. I told you I listen. All right. Thank you again, big bro. Much love, y'all. C.A. Magpie, first song I heard from you was My Life. Blew my mind. That's what's up. Thank you. Thank you. See, I was on them type of times back then. I didn't have my life all the way together, but I've been talking, you know, how I personally feel for a long time. That's a godly voice. Is that word voice?
Golly, voice.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Nofi. All right, perfect answer, my guy. Keep up the good work. Keep up the Lord's work. And amen, my good brother. Peace to you and your queen. May peace be unto you too, and the blessings of God. And may his grace be sufficient enough for you, and his mercies endure every day.
Amen.
All right. Hey, guys, it's been an hour and 4 minutes. We don't want to cut anybody off short, so we're going to read a couple of more, and then we're going to get up off of here. You know, we still have to eat. We ain't fed the little one yet because we wanted to dedicate our time to this right here like we said that we would. So we're going to read a few more, but we will be signing off here in a bit. So please do not be mad if we do not get to your question. All right. Best marital advice y'all can give. Been married almost 6 years and it's been awesome, but I look to make it better. Brennan Saylor. Saylor. I know Brennan, so I know that name. Brennan, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Brennan, you said you've been married almost 6 years and it's been awesome, but I look to make it better. I tell you this, brother, cherish the awesomeness that you're enduring right now. I can't sit here and say that, you know, things are going to start happening bad. But all I say is in all things that are good, you know what I'm saying? In all things that are good, there comes some rough times. There comes some. What's the word I'm looking for? There comes some heavy terrain, you know, in everything that we do in marriage and in a relationship. So cherish these good times that you have going right now. And I'm not sitting here trying to burn bread saying, well, things is going to get bad. I ain't saying that at all. I wish that, you know, you can have another 6 years, you know what I'm saying, of just awesomeness. All I want to do is say, you know, if you keep God first in your life, you know, and you guys have God in your lives, God does not allow us to live our lives without suffering, because if his son Jesus Christ had to suffer, it says in the Bible, then we too must suffer if we love the Lord and if we love God. So we too must suffer. So you guys may have to endure some trials and tribulations along the road, and all I'm saying is that that's not the end of life. You will have to endure those, and you go through those together, and you have each other's back, and you keep the Lord first. He will be with you in all of it. He will be with you in all of it. What you got to say, Brennan?
Brennan, to your question, the best marital advice I can give. First of all, congratulations and blessings to you all for being almost married 6 years, and it's been awesome. That says a lot in itself, because you know, that 7 year mark is definitely, you know, one that is when it kind of is, if they said you can get to 7, you're doing great. So the fact that you are at 6 and it's been awesome, that speaks numbers, that's volumes. That is a blessing, truly. But your question was, you want to make it better. Don't forget communication, Brennan. Communication is major in a relationship. If you guys have God in your life, which is going to be very important, because love does not last. There's going to be times you guys don't love each other. There's going to be times you don't want to come home. And we're not burning bread. We're just telling you how it is. And I hope you never have to go through this or experience it. But just be sure to communicate, you and your spouse. Being married 6 years, the same things that you loved 3 years ago, you may not love now. Be sure to share those things with your significant other, your spouse, because people change over time. Don't assume what made her happy 5 years ago makes her happy now. Maybe she liked flowers then, and she doesn't want flowers anymore because they just die. You know, there's so many things that change over the years. So the best thing I have for you is be sure to communicate. Continue to get to know each other. Do not get comfortable. Do not get comfortable in your marriage ever, ever, ever. Because the moment you get comfortable is the moment you stop caring and you become too lax. Treat the relationship as it seems like you may have, as if you could possibly lose her at any time. And as long as people do that, you will always be on your P's and Q's. Communicate. You don't like something anymore. She used to fix this for you. You don't really like it anymore. Say something. Don't just let it go. Keep it fresh. Keep the communication open and keep God first.
That was great. So I hope that answered your question, Brennan. Definitely. What did he say? Silver Stacker. Love your music. Got a signed poster from Strange Music, and your music move. Music moves. Lives. Keep it up. Music moves. Lives. Keep it up. Mm-hmm. That's where we're at. Mm-hmm. All right, y'all.
Letter to my kids. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Letter to my kids. You guys have a good night. Peace and love. Same to you. Much love to you and your wife and family.
Thanks, Silver.
I absolutely agree. I'm beyond grateful for my wife. She was my best supporter when we lost my dad Thanksgiving 2017. Oh, couldn't be more grateful. She's a blessing.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Okay, y'all have a blessed night and peaceful life. Godspeed, Cut. Thank you for all you do. Again, the storm is never over, but I am happy to know you found the eye.
Hallelujah.
Of the storm. Definitely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Nofi. You know what I'm saying? Peace to your whole family, Angie. You're a rock solid foundation in your family. Aww. I can tell. I too am blessed with a strong partner. She holds up, she holds us down, and we would be lost without her. Aww. Keep motivating.
That's wonderful.
That's a blessing.
Thank
That's
you.
A blessing. Much love to you guys. And this is it, the last one. What was your favorite song to write and why? My favorite song to write, A Time to Kill. I used to didn't have one. I used to tell people I don't have a favorite song because they're all different. A Time to Kill is my most favorite song to write. And why? It allowed me to kill the unforgiveness. It allowed me to have the freeness that I never even knew was available to me. It allowed me to be free. Once we did that video last week, both of us, with everything that we've been going through, the spiritual attacks, the strongholds, the demonic attacks, the ups and downs, the infidelity, adultery, everything that I talked about in that video, that one song freed us from all of that. Now, what one song you know? I don't know. I don't know of a song that I wrote that's had that type of power. And that wasn't nothing but the grace of God speaking through me through that song, allowing me to vent all of that stuff out and get everything that I've talked about. All those videos that we did up until last week and that particular song, that's my most favorite song because it's, I can't begin to explain how miraculous that song is. So that's my favorite song. We thank you so much for staying tuned in, for listening, and we thank you for a lot of the questions, for all of the questions that you guys have given us for the lovely last lady, Angie Calhoun, and myself. And we will be signing off. It's time to take a deep breath and exhale. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to chill out. We're going to soak this newness in. We're free. We've been liberated. God is good.
Yes, he is.
We've made it through the storm. We thank you so much for being a part of this. We love you all for the support. We hope these videos have been a blessing to you and have been beneficial. And if not to you, somebody you may know. Continue to share these. If you haven't seen them all, you can always log in and tune in on my YouTube channel, Black Gold Entertainment, Cut Calhoun, Black Gold Entertainment. And look at all these videos over again, the ones you didn't see. And we're out of here right now. And the family, we just like to say bye. You better come over here so you can say bye. You just go dip in there. He don't want to show his face. His beautiful hair is out and he don't like it because he think that's girly. So he don't want to show y'all. He just did like that. He hates it. He want to bring it back up. But thank you. Anything you got to say? Last words, last lady.
I just want to thank you guys for tuning in. This, I know you all said that the videos helped you all, but it was actually therapeutic for us as well. So thank you for your questions. Thank you for tuning in. And just because this segment is over, don't mean that we're not available to answer questions. If we can help you, you can find a way to reach out to us via inbox, Facebook, or whatever. If there's something serious that you really want to get our opinions on, okay?
Yeah.
Thanks so much for tuning in. God bless you all.
Good night.
Truth be told.
Truth.
Let go.
Yeah.